endure hardship with us like a good soldier of Christ Jesus. No one serving as a soldier gets involved in civilian affairs. He wants to please his commanding officer. Similarly, if anyone competes as an athlete, he does not receive the victor's crown unless he competes according to the rules. The hard-working farmer should be the first to receive a share of crops. Reflect on what I'm saying, for the Lord will give you insight into all this. Remember Jesus Christ, raised from the dead, descended from David. This is my gospel, for which I am suffering, even to the point of being chained like criminal. But God's word is not chained. Therefore, I endure everything for the sake of the elect, that they too may obtain salvation that is in Christ Jesus with glory. Here is a trustworthy saying: if we die with him, we will also live with him. If we endure, we will also reign with him. If we disown him, he will also disown us. If we are faithless, he will remain faithful, for he cannot disown himself. Keep reminding them of these things. Warn them before God against quarreling about words. It is of no value and only ruins those who listen. Do your best to present yourself to God as one approved, a workman who does not need to be ashamed or correctly handles the word of truth. Avoid godless chatter, because those who indulge in it will become more and more ungodly. Their teaching will spread like jelly. Men like them are Hymenaeus and Philetus, who have gone away from the truth. They say that the resurrection has already taken place, and they destroy the faith of some. Nevertheless, God's solid foundation stands firm, sealed with his inscription. The Lord knows those who are his, and everyone who professes the name of the Lord must turn away from their wickedness. In a large house there are articles not only of gold and silver, but also of wood and clay. Some are of noble purposes, and some for ignoble. If a man cleanses himself from the leaven, he will be an instrument for noble purposes, made holy, useful to the master, and prepared to do any good works. Flee the evil desires of youth, and pursue righteousness, faith, love, and peace, along with those who are called on the Lord out of pure heart. Don't have anything to do with foolish and stupid arguments, because you know they produce quarrels. And the Lord's servants must not quarrel. Instead, he must be kind to everyone, able to teach, not resentful. Those who oppose him, he must gently instruct, in the hope that God will grant them repentance, leading them to the knowledge of truth, and that they will come to their senses and escape from the trap of the devil, who has taken their captives to do his will.